Did you know that it's scientifically proven that Native Americans come from Siberia? Since the 18th century, ethnographers and archaeologists have been arguing that there are strong cultural and ethnic similarities between Native Americans and the people of Siberia. So what are those similarities? Well, first of all, appearance and clothes. Apparently, Siberians and Native Americans even look alike. Distinctive cheekbones, an upright posture, and dusky skin. In the 19th century, famous explorer Fridtjof Nansen called Evenks, the indigenous people of eastern Siberia, the Indians of Siberia. Both Siberians and Native Americans dressed themselves in clothes made of deer skin, which makes sense, with deer the main breeding cattle. But what is striking is how similar the ornaments and types of embroidery used to decorate their clothing was. Next, religion and beliefs. Shamanism, belief in the afterlife, and the power of spirits are prevalent for both cultures. Even skin tambourines are used by both Siberian and Indian shamans. In both cultures, they worship the spirit of fire and believe in the world tree as the main pillar of existence. Low alcoholic beverages feature in ceremonies, and while the drinks differ, corn beer for Indians and milk vodka for Siberians, the ritual stays the same. All gather in a circle and drink from one cup, passing it on to the next. Both Siberians and Indians used tattoos as spiritual signs. Their houses looked alike too. Teepees and chums were go-to structures for both Siberians and Native Americans. And then the language. A connection exists between Siberian and Native American languages. In early 18th century, German naturalist Georg Steller, who traveled to Kamchatka and then to North America, argued that either the people of Kamchatka and North America communicated somehow with each other, or Native Americans are the same people as Kamchadals, or are somehow derived from them. After more than a century of speculation, geneticists have proven that Aztecs, Incas, and Iroquois are closely related to the people of Altai, the Siberian region that borders China and Mongolia. Listen to this. Fearless nomadic hunters with strong tribal traditions who believe in the powers of nature and honor spirits of the deceased. This stands true for both Native Siberians and Native Americans. Here's some more evidence for you. In 2008, it was confirmed that the language family of Central Siberia shares a mother tongue with dozens of Native American languages. Researcher Edward Vajda spent several years in Siberia studying the almost forgotten Ket language. His research links the Russian Yeniseian family of extinct languages to the Nadene family of languages spoken by the broad group of present-day Athabascan tribes in the US and Canada. Other evidence is based on genetics and archaeological finds. A skeleton of a four-year-old boy found in South Siberia in the late 1920s led to a fascinating discovery in 2013. These were the oldest human remains from which DNA was extracted. A genetic study of a 24,000-year-old skeleton housed in the Hermitage State Museum in St.Petersburg showed that the boy's DNA had close genetic ties to the DNA of present-day Native Americans. It shows that they carried up to 38% of the genes of the Altai people. But it's not the first archaeological find that suggests that Native Americans and Siberians are related. Let's go back to the 1960s. Soviet historian Nikolai Dikov had found 15,000-year-old human remains in Kamchatka, a region in Russia's Far East. The tomb was unusual for the region. The skeleton was covered in red ochre, just like in the burial traditions of the North American natives. This had led Dikov to believe that ancestors of Native Americans migrated from Siberia. Also, in 2013, two of the world's leading scientific magazines, Nature and Science, published articles about the analysis of whole genomes in Native Americans and their Siberian cousins. The first study analyzed 48 people from Brazil. The second study analyzed 31 genomes from people in the US and Siberia, and the results from both studies confirmed that the ancestors of Native Americans left Siberia about 20 to 30,000 years ago. By the way, scientists already know how humans traveled to the Americas from Altai. Instead of the Bering Strait, there was a land bridge 30,000 years ago, because during the Ice Age, much water was locked in glaciers and the levels of world's oceans were much lower. The 2015 research published by Science by Rasmus Nielsen and his colleagues contacted people whose heritage indicated they were of Native American descent. After analyzing their genome, they proved that about 23,000 years ago, a single group from Northeast Asia crossed the Bering Land Bridge. Then they eventually made their way to Alaska and the rest of America. In that same study, famous Russian geneticist Oleg Polanovsky analyzed DNA samples from the Russian biobank. As a result, scientists proved beyond doubt that Native Americans are closely related to the peoples of Altai. But during that study, another discovery was made. Besides Siberian ancestors, some Native Americans showed a puzzling relation to the indigenous people of Australia and Melanesia in the Pacific Ocean, located in an almost opposite part of the planet. All of this was possible only because of the genome studies which compare various DNA markers. So that's it. The assumptions of researchers and scientists are now proven, and we can say with confidence that Native Americans came to their lands from faraway Siberia.